Welcome back here to the second half action at Perth Hockey Stadium between the Pirates and the Raiders. Is it the Pirates leading 4-0 at halftime? A clinical half on the scoreboard, but probably not in the match. We've seen all sides struggling at the moment, but we'll hope that the second half is a lot better. It was a very flat first half, wasn't it, Jace?
It was very flat. We saw some glimpses of brilliance and some of the capabilities of the real class that is actually out here on the pitch tonight, especially from the Pirates team, but it was a bit of a nothing game.
Certainly a lot of girls showing their hand-eye skills early, wasn't it? I mean, as you said, we've seen some really good moments.
Again. I think that was Patton, that does have the capacity to hit through lines and play quite powerful with the ball.
Bit of pressure here applied by Simmons on the Raiders defenders. The Denning girls again just...
Good pressure started early.
Again, those two just refusing to back down.
Well, you look at that little patch there. You've got Simons, whose pressure skills are outstanding, and then you have both the Denning girls on top of them. So not a nice little patch of grass to have the ball with.
Raiders this time have the numbers back. We saw in the first half some of those passes were able to catch them off.
Pressure by Turner and Denning. So they've started, their pressure skills have been very, very good in the early minutes.
Well, you think that they would have got a talk to as well. I know you can look at the score and say 4-0.
Oh,
and as we said at halftime, for people just joining us at halftime, you say 4-0. It wasn't a clinical 4-0 throughout the game. So you would have thought they would have got the same talking to as the Raiders would have almost.
Maybe more.
Because we wouldn't be happy.
You don't win premierships by going through the motions coming into finals, so I'm sure they wouldn't have been happy.
No, certainly not. So we're hoping to see a bit of a lift in the second half. Got to say, the two Denny girls couldn't lift any more after what we saw in the first half. They were two that just kept on going.
Ambitious 40-metre pass by Squibb back into the midfield, but hit a target. Plays a bit like a quarterback in gridiron. Squibb sits in the pocket, can hit targets over distance, through lines. Very, very good passer of the ball.
And we saw that again there. So trying to go through again was Kelly White, unable to.
Not dancing to the right songs tonight, is she?
No. Has been just caught up a few times.
Played Aaron. And get forward.
So White now. She this time. This time she just goes back and puts it out in front of Denning, who runs onto it perfectly.
Well, she's
this time a freshie.
Oh, it's clever.
Yeah, trick. That was planned.
Would have to be the form she's in at the moment. Her appetite for the ball, she is insatiable.
They've been going very well, both of them. One thing just noticing then off the camera as well, and I think it's something you talked about, it might be even the frustration from the Raiders with players not playing and just a whole lot of things, is just how quickly their heads are dropping at times, sometimes too, when a pass isn't completed.
And that's the attitudinal stuff we spoke about. A real bugbear of mine there, Penny Squibb, receiving the ball on the outside, getting pressed and trying to slap the ball from a stationary position, just getting run down. We'll be having a chat about that tomorrow morning.
Yeah, well, some of these girls got to be up nice and early, don't they, Jace?
They do.
It's not just you who's backing up, mate.
7 a.m. Diamonds training tomorrow morning.
Yeah, so plenty to talk about, I'm sure. Another short corner here. We haven't seen them score off the short corner yet, the Pirates, but they have shown some good sets, haven't they?
Yeah.
Let's see if they can execute from one of these. We've seen Chialella at the post twice. One gets her in it. She got a deflection and went wide. And the next one just missed her. They don't try to go to her this time. It's kicked away by Wells. Denning gives chase.
Not sure if Squibb was trying to find a deflection target there or just slide one in between Ash's legs when she stood up.
Again, Denning, the pressure. She does well, wins it back. She'll give chase again here.
Be careful.
Continues to give
the
pressure. And yeah, she almost got the... tap with a stick.
As Kingy comes back on the field.
One person who doesn't look like they'll be coming on the field is Rivers. Saw her at half time. She's gone back in the dugout. Probably has a nice little golf ball on the side of her head.
Yeah, we did see her moving around though, and she's not the type to just throw it away. So hopefully we can see her back out there because at least we'll see some fire.
Well, she was one that was going very hard for the Raiders. Is there a chance here?
Oh, great save.
Called on was Wood. And she was able to get the save, as you said, a very good save. I think it was Power, actually.
It looked like this. It looked like, yeah.
So Alicia Power
struggling
in goals.
To see the numbers from here, but yeah. It looked like Alicia's movement. So and
it was a great save.
And I think we discussed earlier, Alicia Power is one of the up-and-coming stars in terms of goalkeepers in the country. She is now.
She showed that then, didn't she? The speed and the way she stood there and took that save.
Good positioning and a slight little reaction save. Got it clean. Good run here by Turner as well.
We've certainly seen some good keeping. Chialella's just snuck on forward. She'll get this one too. She did that quite well, actually. Right. That was sneaky.
She is a phantom. She just managed to get behind the play and get in the right places.
If it comes back to we get a stop and play, we'll mention what we saw here because it would have been off camera. The Raiders are able to clear, but only as far as Squibb looks up, and she might just put it straight back into Chialella, who's at the post again. She's there, and it goes just over top.
We've seen that from Patton and Squibb, so they've got some people who can really make incisive passes over distance.
Well, for those who didn't see, Chialella was on the boundary line, ended up deviating off, waited, and then sprinted when she saw herself cut into the deep. Perfect timing. And even then at the back post again, if you watch her,
here she's again.
She just knows when to go. She goes right now deep into the post. She'll run into the middle. She'll be a chance for the deflection.
She's
very smart.
We need a Chialella tracker. Yeah, just watch her on the side.
We might say press red for Chialella. She knows exactly what's going on, doing very well.
Well, she only has one intent and reason to be out there. She's looking to score. You can see everything she does is related to that.
Fast break chance here for the Raiders. 3-on-2 at the moment. They'll be hoping to get it. It's 3-on-2, almost, because they had 3-on-1 in the end. The fast break.
It's a good running on the outside by Shania Tonkin as well. Another one of the quality young kids we talked about with Raiders. So that's a good sign, working hard. Sometimes what happens when you're at this stage in a game, you're getting beaten soundly, people stop running and stop taking chances because they're just waiting for the ball to come back, essentially. So it's a good sign.
Well, it looks like the effort's picked up on both sides at the moment, but it's still a very flat game.
I certainly think it's probably picked up a little bit, a bit sharper, a little bit more intensity.
It almost had to after that first half. I don't think it could have gone the other way. So we've gone...
No, everything has a bottom point, doesn't it?
We reached it there. Normally, when you see 4 goals go in, you wouldn't think that was the case, but it certainly was. So Hammond comes off. Didn't look too happy. The side now... For the Pirates, Denning presents.
And you hope Hammond's okay. They need her out in the pitch as well.
Mm. Another one that showed a bit of fight for the Raiders.
Definitely another one of their seasoned players that's had a good season as well.
So what can they do with it from right in the back? And it's Del Borello there.
There's a crack, Del Borello. She's still fighting, wants the ball, wants to take responsibility, wants to be in the contest. Really good signs for a young kid.
Runs hard a lot of the time as
Absolutely.
Well.
Absolutely.
So right on the last line now for the Pirates. Denning, again, just controlling.
Still wanted to go forward there a bit, but it's very good at getting the ball in congestion.
Denning back to Squibb, to Patton. Patton down the line where she finds Stora. Stora into Denning.
Go forward.
Denning looks up. She does. Finds Turner this time.
Started coaching there.
That's all right. We like the coaching as well. It has probably been something that's been noticeable today that her first action is actually to go back rather than forward.
Certainly a part of her, say, individual development plan to work on trying to get more of an open body with her, some of her receives. She's going to receive the ball back to play a lot because of the position she plays in, but her default is to peel and then to go back. So we definitely want her to go forward and to take more risks and get to daylight instead of knocking the ball back.
Well, she's got it here, and she's just hit white in the leg, so now she's dancing. You mentioned her dance move now. She's caught one there, and that's going to hurt.
She's not going to help how she's feeling.
No, not at all. She's on all fours at the moment. And she might limp when she gets up here. Yeah, that was not the nicest one.
There's a lot of injured hockey roos around at the moment, so that's not going to help the tally.
Hammond's back on now. missing another one. Hammond cops one here, so we're seeing some strange things here tonight, Jace.
Well, you got to laugh.
There's some miss hits. There's balls hitting people left, right and centre. There's not much else going on the pitch. So Storer into the middle to Squibb. Squibb will go across. She found Patton to Denning.
Great forward structure. You won't see a lot of that on the TV, but good spacings, had the areas covered they needed to. It's a really good setup by Curtin there.
Obviously not allowed to get away with that one, though, the Pirates, but we saw Kingy as well with nice control. You mentioned that earlier.
Yeah, it's been quiet, though. But I guess when you've got the calibre and the depth that this group has, it is difficult to get a lot of ball into shine, I suppose. They share the load very well.
In through the middle now, through Patton again. Good tackle there.
Overplayed that a bit, just need to simplify it and kick the ball out.
It's a good tackle by the player in the middle of the Raiders play. Again, we can't see the numbers from here, but she did well. Turner into the D. A call, they should get it. They do, the short corner now. So 23 minutes to go here in the second half, 4-0.
It's good hockey by Pirates too, just getting back quick. Quick passing game, shifting the ball to space, and then once they've got it out, making some runs and taking some risk going to the circle. Well, they've got to get one of these soon, mate, surely.
You'd think so, because they haven't been bad at them all. I'd love to know the average age of the two sides out here, because, I mean, we've touched on that some of the Pirates girls look quite young. I think there's a big age difference here watching some of them come to the bench.
Well, it'll
be very interesting to just see the average age across the board.
There's a lot of kids playing for, look at that save. A lot of kids playing for Raiders, but they also have a number of seasoned veterans as well. The frightening thing for the competition is that this Pirates team is full of young 20-year-olds.
Yeah.
Not a young team, but an up-and-coming team starting
still
to get
five.
Experience, getting games.
Yeah.
The AFL talk about their 50 games. This is this team. Their premiership window is beginning now, and they've already got one.
Yeah, that's always a scary sign for the competition when you can see their window being open by more than 2 or 3 years.
Well, I think it's a lot bigger than that.
Yeah, so keeping the girls together would be the main plan, but
well,
doing it well.
As these kids get better, they're going to have issues with the salary cap, so that will be something they'll have to deal with.
The Raiders player there that lost the ball, dropped the head, lost it through the middle.
Oh, Katie needs to do better there.
Simon's there. She might get a chance to do it back. She gets it back now.
Good skills.
Denning in the middle. This time looks forward first, then goes back. Now looks up again. Still doing well to maintain it. She gets it through now to the far side. Looks in there is Flynn.
It's a great ability to keep the ball, Kate. It's really strong. The problem with that is it's a bit of a black hole, all that. The offense stops moving off you when you don't give the simple passes and you can't punch the ball out quickly from your receives and your movement forward. So
the post, there's a few options there. One is Crombie, who's already scored. She puts it just wide. One thing we're noticing with Denning that I've just seen from there, although she turns it back and in, you mentioned the good control, she's always looking up as well at the time, either whether it's back or forward. She's looking up to see who she can pass to, why she's got the control. She just seems to know exactly where it is.
Very good at retaining the ball. There's not many better in terms of getting the ball in congestion, being able to keep the ball, being able to move to spaces and create things for people to play off. The thing we've got to keep working with her to get better at is she's got to make the passes she sees and back herself to play a quicker passing game.
Squibb ended up intercepting it. Gets turned over now and it's taken by Serafini. A nice pass by Serafini. It opens up for the Raiders as they enter the D. A great tackle there by Squibb. They wanted the call, some of the fans.
Didn't look great, but it's pretty clean.
So Squibb did well. Now,
good little play by Flynn.
Again, just too much time.
Good skill, though.
Did well to get it back.
Fumble with it early.
So Del Borello fending off the player. It opened up again, but just not incredibly clean at all stages. Again, glimpses. 20 minutes to go here. 4-0 still. Squibb.
Clever ball.
Opened it up. She went to put it in the day, no luck, the pressure. With Simons in the end again. Gave that one away. A risky pass, it's doesn't better. Come off.
Quick passing.
Kingy now, just outside the D. She moves just into the D, gets a...
Not happy though, looking for the penalty corner.
Denning to Simons, no one at the post. Can tell that Chialella's off because she would have been there.
The other thing you can tell, and I'm not sure if it relates to Chialella, but in the last few minutes since then, the forward structure, we mentioned the forward structure is very good. In the last few forays forward, has been really poor. People just leading for themselves and sitting on top of each other. And that could be them all looking for that next goal. Things are too easy, or it could be related to some of their leaders not being on the pitch.
Well, she's on again now, and she's just planning a run perfectly to the post. So
clever again. We hardly saw her come on the field.
Yeah, she ran. Well, she actually ran forward, deviated back because she realised that they'd gone backwards, and then she ran forward again when she saw the play moving. So she reads it perfectly. I don't know if I've seen another girl in the games we've called so far this season who's actually willing to do a lot of them. If they'll just run out, and if it does get turned out, they'll continue on their path. She deliberately turns back and then goes again.
Very, very clever and very purposeful about all her off-the-ball movements, trying to create herself passing channels either on the inside or the outside, always trying to get ahead of the play and get in behind, and always thinking about getting good position so that she can get shots from. You know, she as we said, she's a pure finisher. She's looking to score.
And we've just seen another player go down here. This doesn't look good at all. I think it's Del Borello. You can hear from the crowd.
Had a bit of heat on that too.
Yeah, so that one's certainly going to hurt. Denning goes in as well to make sure she's okay. This has been one of the strangest games I've ever seen, Jace.
Oh.
You don't wish this on any side, but this is just odd.
Unfortunately, part of the competition is with AOS players coming in and out and the depth of what that does to your depth. You sort of get to this phase of the year, and if you have a few injuries plus that, you can get to this sort of situation. And it is a little bit like watching a car crash unfold, because they then get more injuries because people are stretched, and then these sort of things happen as well. And
well, now it looks like they've lost Del Borello and Rivers, two of their most prominent players.
Well, Del Borello's been brave. Really outstanding effort for a young kid.
She's meant to be at training in the morning, isn't she?
No, it was Wednesday morning.
Oh, that's all right then. So she's got a few days to rest. That's okay then. Just going back to Chialella, but even watching then, just before that happened, the player happened to mark her. Just watching her, and all of a sudden she's turned back again. She's gone again because she used the goalie. I was watching her just off camera. She used the goalie to make room. So she's just incredibly smart. And as you said, will do absolutely anything just to get free and to find space. And
well, the other thing she's very good at when she runs ahead of the players, she continually gets herself in behind the defenders and gets them turning. Every time they turn to find her, she'll pop back onto another passing channel. So she doesn't leave them alone. You have to be very on your guard and very switched on to mark from in front and to handle Chialella's movements off the ball. We just get a cheer for Tash as she walks off, so it looks like she's going to be okay, which is great.
Just limping nicely, but giving everyone a wave.
As a young warrior would.
Yeah, that's it. Tell ya, this sport's not for the soft-hearted at all.
No, we've
seen some big hits, haven't we?
People laugh about hockey and the physicality, and it's a dangerous game. Dangerous on the edge.
It is. We've seen that tonight. Two big hits. So Denning went to Storer. To Simons, back to Storer. They come right back now to Squibb. They go to the far side. Now we're hearing some yelling from the coaching, the Raiders coach say.
Well,
calling some plays across, because all of a sudden we've got 3-on-2 on this side where they've managed to go through Storer.
It's good by Curtin, just shifting the ball around, really patient. I could probably lift their passing rate and get rid of the ball a bit quicker, but it's at a reasonable level. So
that was probably the best passing play we've seen tonight, I reckon. So now the Raiders try to go forward. Again, with no luck, Denning does very well. Now she should use Simon. She does. She runs on. She might get it back. She does.
Simon
gets it. Will there be options? Dangerous there, but that was better playable. Again, Denning's been doing it all night, so we're not surprised. But
no, Kate deserved more from Katie there. Just didn't need to lift it. only had a small gap to get through, but Cuddy has a skill to do that, and outstanding skill. And the pleasing thing, as we've talked about, is Kate getting forward on that play. Fantastic.
Well, it's turnover again. Chialella.
It's going to be a goal.
She's trying to pounce. Running through was Crombie. They had a taut there. Crombie might have had a clean shot. But it's just starting to open up again in the last few minutes.
A little bit. The half has, we're 20 minutes in now, and the half has dragged.
It's taken a while, hasn't it?
It's felt like the oxygen's been sucked out of it that whole 20 minutes.
Well, we haven't really seen a shot.
No, it's just been...
It's been up there all the time, but it hasn't, hasn't been a real shot. And it kind of summarises the match. The highlights at the moment might be some of your calls earlier about fish heads and whatever else is going on in this game. So
it'd be fair to say we're a little bit clumsy too through the first half, but we have to react off the game.
You do, and that's sometimes that's what happens. So Denning gets it. Again, the fumble. Oh. We're not looking forward. Get it now, Denning. What's going on?
Oh, my. That play sums up the game.
Well, now we still haven't had a call. Now we finally got it. So I don't know what we're doing here.
The crowd's restless as well.
Yep. This is just summarising the night these past few minutes. There's still 15 minutes to go. 4-0. Now we've got a fix that there's a strange song coming on, I think. I don't know what we're dealing with.
What?
It's all coming apart here at the Perth Hockey Stadium tonight. The Pirates up 4-0 over the Raiders. The short corner now for the Pirates. We've seen them do it okay tonight. They still haven't scored off one yet, but which they would be disappointed in.
They will be disappointed.
Can they do it now?
Very
Squibb.
Clean.
She get it back.
Good first, good effort there.
Another chance. Still another chance. Good saving there by Ashley Wells, called upon multiple times.
Well, I think it was Evans coming out as the first runner. Did a great job to block that. What Curtin have done really well is they've been clean with their push-outs and their traps. They just haven't been able to get on the ball quick enough for some of their direct shots. And it's probably just lacks a bit of conviction about what they're doing. It looks nice and it looks clinical, but you've still got to score.
I know you'd be all over it, Jace, with the amount of hockey you watch in a week. How worried would you be as the Pirates coach at the moment watching this performance tonight? I mean, obviously they've been playing well all year, but a game like this, they haven't shown a lot. I know that you can be brought down by your opposition, but you'd still like to see a clinical performance this time of year.
Of course, but if I was coaching Curtin, we would have a high five and say, got the points and never talk about it again.
Move on next week.
Yep.
Sometimes it's easier done.
You don't want to discuss it or dwell on it because you don't want it to become a factor that can relate to your form going forward.
Yeah.
The reality is they've beaten a team that's fifth comfortably and is no. And that's why you don't want to talk about it going into the week. But, yeah, they've got the points. It's comfortable and they have been in really good form. They've got a healthy list. So, you know, there are no negatives to be dwelling on.
No, as you said, the point's the most important thing, and I guess if you put them in the bank, yeah, as you said, you can move on. So again, Chialella, almost a chance. That was a good ball in by Simons.
It's a great target. Del Brello warming up, so she's not going to let it slide.
No, she's top pace now.
We saw Simons too with that ball. She has the ability to hit the ball on the move like no one else in this league. It's a fantastic little pass. Underestimate how difficult that is to be able to hit on the move. That accurately and that cleanly.
And that's been the sad thing about tonight is that, as we said, we keep going back to glimpses, but that's what we've seen. We've seen some passages of play or moments that have been absolutely sensational, but we just haven't been able to string it together or see a long passage of it. Some of the traps tonight and the skills with the hands have been
Teases,
ridiculous.
Yeah. I was really looking forward to seeing some of the key players in the Curtin team, and probably a little bit disappointed we don't see to get these two teams with Parker and Paris and co going head to head, because that would be a fantastic game of hockey. But even still, tonight had the makings of a real display of skill and class, because there's a lot of it out there and we haven't seen much of that at all. So it probably has been a disappointing game.
12 minutes to go here, 4-0 as we said to the Pirates. They have not been troubled at all. I think we can call one save, and it was this half where power was called upon.
And an outstanding save.
It was a very good save, one from one. So with Denning, she went back to Denning as well. Across now. Look up. They've got options. Mistrap there by Simons.
Oh, Katie.
They get it back on the far side now. They cut through the middle. There's options everywhere. Denning looks up. Finds Flynn. Flynn's got options ahead as well. She moves it on quickly. Again, there's still options in the middle if they're willing to put it back in. It's with Capewell. She didn't get away with it quick enough in the end because they had a few. Now Mash, what can the Raiders do on the quick break possibly? Not a lot. Straight into the foot of Hammond. So Denning again.
Well, that's 30 seconds of our lives we'd like to get back.
Very hard to lift for this game at the moment. We're trying, but there just hasn't been a lot, has it? Again, the turnover through the middle. Can they? There's three on two here behind. Surely this has got to go in. Kingy goes just wide. She's kicking herself over that opportunity as well. 10 minutes to go here. The Pirates move it inboard. Turner, Metzola, she gets it back. Turner, shot on goal. Wells does well.
Turner. Good receive to advantage. Got the quick shot away.
And Wells is in a perfect position again.
Not a power hitter, Sophie. Has good basic skills, and so there's not enough power. She certainly can't hit it at that height and expect to beat Ash Wells from the top of the circle. But some good execution with the things leading into it. So
been impressed with the goalless tonight, Jase, for both. Can say that. Both have shown plenty.
A lot of work for Ash Wells, and the small amount of work that Alicia's had to do has been pure class.
It's another short corner to not now. Music still playing just to see if they can pump the girls up.
Oh, good.
And it might have worked. They've got it through. I don't know who has come off in the end, but the music playing through the short corner obviously worked. They've scored. It wasn't clinical, but it's gone in.
Doing some sound checks here just towards the end of the game. There's a good corner. It looked like Kingy came in from the left. A difficult corner to defend and a difficult corner to execute, but that was pretty well drilled. And they've been, we're probably up to around 10-plus corners now. And as we've said, there hasn't been enough conviction with what they've done. It's looked nice and neat all night, but really hasn't really threatened the Raiders' defence. So it's good to see them get one.
Well, the first goal of the second half. There's 8 minutes to go. It's 5-0 now to the Pirates over the Raiders.
And she's a miser as ever, Kirsty Denning. She's not going to give them anything.
With this win, Jase, it will put them on 9 wins. It'll put them one game just behind UWA.
You'd have to think it'll settle the 4-2. I think it's pretty well settled.
Certainly
anyway,
looks at doing that. The Raiders will be still behind YM and Vic Park as well after this. Game behind both.
Vic Park have been undermanned in recent weeks as well, but they've shown much more fight than what Raiders have shown here tonight. And I would expect that they're going to be able to carry themselves through.
So the record, as we said, it will mean that the Pirates have played 14 and they would have won 9 now. They've only lost one for the season as well. So, as you said, points in the bank. They continue on their good form. And continue marching towards the finals.
It's going to be a great final series. There's been a bit of a gap between some of the younger teams in the comp. They probably lack a bit of depth and have struggled, especially when their Australian players have been away. But the top teams in our competition are world class. So the final series is going to be tough and uncompromising and exciting, I would have thought. For me, a UW Curtin final at this stage, pending how things go. I think YM probably a little bit off those two. But the question then will be whether the youth and the class of this Curtin team can stand up to almost a bit of a mission that I see this older UWA team on.
Del Brella's back on for the Raiders. She played a part in that.
Straight involved.
Yeah, she was running on. Could have been a chance, could have been used. She's still a chance at the top of the D, and that's a shocking pass there by Mash.
Collective groan around the stadium as...
And it could get a little bit louder here because they've got a few options now on the counter prize. Kingy, Chialella had time to run perfectly. We're smack on it again. She's giving chase, Chialella.
If you're not watching and then you scan to look where you think the next person has the best chance of getting it, she'll be there.
Well, she looks like she's going to come off every time. We're looking at the moment. She's just cruising towards the line. She's a big chance here if we get on again. She's peeling back.
Well, they have the luxury of playing what I call a cheating striker or an outlier. So she doesn't work back into the midfield event. She works. Oh, here we go.
Well, she's got it again. Oh, she's just gone past. I think she was almost worried about being tripped.
Yeah, umpire Cowan looked like he's putting his hands up. There's
like
possible foul there. But yeah, she plays as a high striker, and her job is to break and to create those opportunities. So she's probably quite pleased that she has a role where she doesn't have to do a lot of defensive work.
Yeah, and
good fun.
Well, you don't complain about that at all, do you? Just timing your runs and hiding between the boundary line and the fence and behind poles and goalies.
Tiptoeing through the dugout on transition.
She's having fun out there playing a game with herself. She has showed plenty of skills, but on a serious note. And again, that's another great example there by Flynn of some of the top skills we have seen tonight at stages. Del Borello back on.
It's interesting, you think through some of the class of the Pirates and you think a lot of them have been quiet, and yet the Raiders haven't really had the ball. So the feeling of them being quiet, I guess, relates to that it's been fumbly and clumsy, and the class and the clean bits of play have been broken up with that type of stuff.
Certainly an interesting one. 5 minutes to go here. It is 5-0 still to the Pirates. Sloppy pass here. Chialello breaks. She might get this in a second.
In out.
She does. She got Kingy just at the post. It was a great pass. Kingy, Chialello still there. And again, Kingy just takes her time.
That was poor.
Just couldn't get it to settle. Kept going, rolling away to her left. She kept stepping and waiting for it to stop. Kept going, and then late again.
It looked like she's trying to set it up to slide it back to Chialella, which would have been the play.
Caught in two minds.
Of course, Chialella was setting herself up for that. But
it was a good pass by Chialella as well, wasn't it? She had the vision and awareness.
We had seen her leading. She came in, out, defender turned. She set that up to T.
It would actually be good tonight if we had a camera on. The Raiders a chance here. Del Borello,
a great save
again. Alicia Power, 2 from 2 tonight. She has been called upon twice.
Outstanding.
And has been, that was sensational. I think a lot of goalies would have just conceded that that was going to go in because it was set up perfectly. She had to move from her left to her right, and she managed then to do that and come out and meet Del Borello and still stop it.
Fantastic young talent.
As we said, the goalies can hold their heads up high tonight. They've been sensational.
And I think we didn't finish on Chialella, did we? Just with the work. And
she's just hiding behind the goalkeeper.
But yeah, if we pan back now, she's actually standing with the goalkeeper.
The short corner comes in. Now's a shot. A great finish.
Well, a bit of crowd education.
Yeah.
Obviously, on your first strike.
It's a good finish, wasn't it? But still, obviously.
In open play, not a corner.
No.
Chialella again.
She was still chatting with the goalie while all that was happening. Was in the perfect spot still.
One of the interesting byplays as we head into finals will be if Curtin think that they can play with her cheating out the back or outlier, whatever term you want to use, whether they can expose Curtin for having that and Chialella not defending and getting behind the ball. That will be an interesting thing to see whether that tactically changes or whether they can get away with it.
Especially against a side like UWA.
Of course, but still, you know, it becomes a gamble. UW turn over the ball in the wrong place and then it's an easy break, and we know Chialella's so dangerous. So little things like that will be some interesting byplay as we come into the finals with the different tactics that the teams play.
Would love to have a camera on her, and I know we've said a few times, but it's just been absolutely fascinating watching her off camera, the way she just ducks, dive, weaves, find positions, comes and goes.
Oh, for me, I'd love to have some footage of some of her leading, getting behind, her leading.
It's almost like a footy player.
It's exceptional.
I haven't seen it much, especially not in the girls, but even in the men's grades, people are just going once, going twice, going three times before the ball finally comes to them.
Well, and the ability to manipulate passing channels and move, shift defenders, there is some real serious smarts about how she operates.
Well, the key thing that you mentioned there as well is now that almost a chance with Chialella again, who was going to go to, is that she's able to move the defenders, because a lot of the time as well, they're watching her that much and then they follow her, that she's allowed some of the other strikers. We've seen Kingi come free in the last few minutes as well, just because of her movement.
Absolutely.
Del Borello, the D, she's come back very good considering the hit she took. Looking for the call again with the Raiders. They're not happy.
A couple of free hits and all that, I think.
Now they get it. And I think we're going to see a card here. There was a little bit of talking. So the yellow is going to go to Crombie. Crombie asking about it. There's only a minute 15 left. You can go have a shower nice and early. She's still not happy.
No.
So she did score the first goal tonight.
And she's still not happy.
No, 5-0. The score at the moment. The Raiders, can they get one on the board? They've been pushing. Del Borello, she's going to look to take it. Been impressed with her courage coming back.
Absolutely. She is a good young kid.
Kingi there is able to just gain a few metres. We're turning now. We're under a minute. Flynn goes right across and finds Patton.
Great ball.
Really nice pass down the line.
It's good movement there, Flynn to Patton down the line. Just quick ball movement.
So doing well, Squibb. Ends up going back
to
Flynn. 2-on-1 here. Could be 3-on-1 in a minute. The Raiders' numbers win out. Now they've got an option on the fast break. There's
good chase just by under. Kyra. Look at the shot. Oh.
Cops one there, and again the chase, as you said, Denning just all night. There's 20 seconds left, and she's still willing to do the little things. Can they score with 6 seconds left? Definitely not now. That'll be the end here. An interesting, nice chase. 5-0, as you said. I think the Pirates will just take the points, put them in the bank, look towards next week, but certainly a different game.
Not a great night to remember. There's still glimpses for the viewers at home, and we can certainly see the classes out on the pitch tonight, but Pirates really struggled to get into any sort of consistent rhythm throughout the game, and Raiders were probably lucky that they managed to get the game into a holding pattern in the second half, so the game didn't blow out to being a cricket score.
Well, a 5-0 result, as we said, to the Pirates over the Raiders. We saw captain of the Raiders, Rivers, go down after being hit. We saw Del Borello go down and come back on. Certainly an interesting night here for the Pirates. It gives them their 9th win for the season and means that they are well and truly cementing their spot in the top two, and the Raiders will stay outside the top four. It's all your action here from the Perth Hockey Stadium for Local Sports Online. We'll be back again next Friday night with Game of the Week.